All right, it's a Pick Your Hunter, and today we're going to do a review of the Amazfit GTR 3, GTR 3 Pro, specifically looking at their training load workout analysis features. So I've been using this for about 2 months. I've tested the GTR 3 Pro, and I've gone back just to the standard GTR 3, but I love it as a watch. I love it just wearing it day to day. I feel like it's the perfect design. It's sleek. It's awesome. The screen is brilliant and beautiful. The widgets work. It gets all my notifications. It syncs with the app. Everything works so well. But one of the things I loved about it initially was that it was keeping up a relative accurate heart rate when for an optical heart rate sensor. So I'm re-reviewing the heart rate accuracy, and you need to watch that video, which I'm releasing in tandem with this video. So a re-review of the heart rate accuracy for doing CrossFit workouts and wearing the watch on the wrist. But I'm also giving a long-term review here today of the training load, training effect, and recovery time estimates that I'm constantly getting from the watch, because I wanted to see, like, over a long period of time, is it going to get more accurate? Because I was getting, like, full strain, full peaked out training effect, you know, like I was crushing my body in every workout, and I had to see it long-term to see if it would come down and settle in. So we're going to look at that. We're going to look at the accuracy there. We're going to look at it first in the app just to see the training load after 7 days of relatively light work. So I'm going to show you the training load on the app after a couple of Metcons and a couple of just sort of get out there and sweat workouts. Nothing too strenuous. And we're going to look at some of the heart rate accuracy, but again, it's in that re-review in the, and down in the description below. And then we're going to look at the actual training load, training effect metrics it's giving after every workout, which obviously flows from that training load. We're going to touch on the recovery time, but obviously that flows as well from what it's assuming your workout exertion scores are. So with that, let's look at it all and come back together and talk about
it. Okay, so one of the most interesting things about the Amazfit GTR 3 and the GTR 3 Pro is the fact that it tracks your workouts. I mean, it does great with sleep. You know, it's got these breathing quality aspects, stress, and SpO2, but it has this exercise status, which is super similar to Garmin's status. We're gonna look at the training effect, and we're just gonna touch for a millisecond on the recovery time in a second. But I wanna show you one thing before I show you the workouts that led to this maxed out, fully overloaded training load. So here it doesn't look quite as horrific, but you can see in my workouts, I have gone from, you know, because there was a period of time where I actually was waiting for a new version of the watch. I have gone to peaked out status. Now it says green, but this is really what it thinks it says. I mean, this is what it perceives me to be. If you look on the right, the Epoch 1473, the training load, it's always giving me gargantuan training load scores. Where if you look at the Garmin training load system, you're getting much more reasonable, much more normal training load lines. So 684, this is what the workout's been, this is what is real life, and they're basing it on the same type of tracking system with the Epoch and the training load, but it has me fully redlined. Now, this doesn't look fully redlined because they use green, but it is still at the peak of the training load bar. And we'll see right now what those workouts entail. And we'll also look at the training effect. As you can assume from this training load, if you are redlining your training load, the recovery time on the watch is always multiple days, 2 days of recovery from every workout, because it is perceiving my training load to be that strenuous when really I'm sort of like just in the middle, not overdoing it, nothing crazy. Let's look at some of the workouts in detail. Okay, so in this workout, it was super casual. Just basically, you know, 20 minutes of just sort of very light work with a little strain at the end, barely. You can see that the heart rate was actually accurate in this one. It kept up with the strain, so we can now see how it relates on the training load scores, or actually the training effects. So it said 3.3, this is on the Amazfit, anaerobic 1.1, and the Garmin 2.7 and 0. And at best it was 2.7. So if you look at just the overall average heart rate, it's just smooth, steady state. This was mostly just an elliptical, absolutely not really peaking my fitness. Then you have a double Metcon workout of the day. So it was basically two Metcon sort of back to back. It was a little bit higher strain. Here you can see the heart rate accuracy is not accurate. It's saying I got a maximum of 184. My average was 142. Average really 134. So that's pretty off. And then the Amazfit saying I just peaked out. So if you see what you see here, this is what I see pretty much in every CrossFit workout. When I'm really, whenever I cross my heart rate over 162 beats per minute and I stay in the zone five for a period of time, this is what I'm getting over and over again. And right now, after a relatively hard workout, well, we'll look at it in a second. So 3.3 was my actual, and then 2.0 in the anaerobic. That's fair because it was a double Metcon, so I was keeping the heart rate peaked out, but definitely not fully maxed out to the brim. This was 100% accurate from Garmin. Here's a super steady state workout, average beats 144 beats per minute. And then here, the heart rate accuracy is obviously off. It said I maxed out at 189. You have a hole in accuracy in the middle there, and then it actually gets relatively smooth towards the end. Again, because I had a heart rate that said high, you know, I mean, it wasn't a super long workout, 31 minutes. It was just 31 minutes just on light strain and, you know, 4.7, 4.5. Obviously, the heart rate inaccuracy could be applying to this, but anytime, and I mean anytime, I go to do a CrossFit workout, if there's 15 minutes of strain, it'll say maxed out versus 3.4. That's totally accurate. And then this was the workout tonight, and I'll tell you my recovery time on the watch in a second. So, you know, just some lifting in the beginning, you know, it was 7 rounds and the 3-minute intervals, and then I just did some light work afterwards, 135 beats per minute. Here, 149 beats per minute average. That is way off in the accuracy, and obviously I did a separate video about that, but it just says maxed out. 5.0, 4.3. And again, you could say this is related to heart rate accuracy, but this is what I see even when the heart rate is somewhat accurate. So what you see here is what I see when the heart rate is actually tracking similarly to a chest strap versus what it should be tracking, which, boom, this is 100% right. So we can see that in general, this is what I'm seeing all the time. And as of right now, from this workout here, I am now sitting with my watch and it is showing a recovery time of 70 hours. So it was basically a 21-minute Metcon and it was like 400-meter interval runs and 12 chest to bars repeated every 3 minutes. And I have 70 hours to recover. I've got to take the next 3 days off because it's 400-meter intervals with 12 chest to bars really crushed my soul, which it clearly did not. So that is all for the training load, recovery time.
So what do I think about the Amazfit GTR3 Pro or GTR3 and GTR3 Pro? I think that they have built a fundamentally awesome system. I feel like it is spot on with connecting to the app. It's spot on with syncing the information, spot on with getting my notifications, spot on with getting weather widget to update. Even Garmin, who is, I continually believe, is one of the best, doesn't always get the weather widget updated. When you go down and scroll down into it, Amazfit just works. Plus, it's got a beautiful screen of all of the lower end, lower cost, like the Huawei, Honor, Xiaomi. Of the watches I've tested, this has the best choice of watch faces. And that is a silly thing, but I scrolled through a bajillion Huawei faces and I could not find a watch face that I just thought, this is awesome and simple. And I feel like the Amazfit GTR 3 has it. So I love it as a watch and it's functionally, it just works. But what we see in the workout analysis from the training load, training effect, and recovery times is that it is just not accurate at this point in time. It is December 2021. So you cannot trust it as any kind of workout evaluation because what I have found, and I would take it out on a run, I would get a VO2 max score, and I would, you know, I would, it wasn't like it was unaware of a fitness level. If I did a Metcon that has 20 minutes of work in it and I'm getting my heart rate in the zone 4 and zone 5 and just right averaging right in there, even if the heart rate was keeping up, it is just saying I'm like fully redlined. My training effect in the aerobic, training effect and training effect in the anaerobic, fully redlined. And my recovery time, 3 days of recovery, and my training load, you know, 1,000 units of epoch. So it is just not at all up to par right now. And I'm going to keep the watch, and I'm probably going to keep wearing it just to take an eye, keep an eye on it. But it is not up to par. So I had to get that out because I did a really glowing review because I really love it as a watch. And I was impressed initially with the heart rate accuracy in general for an optical. You got to check the re-review down below. And now I just have to disclose some of these things that it's just not quite up to snuff. And I bought the watch with my own money so I can say whatever I want. With that, that's the Fit Gear Hunter. Thanks so much for watching.